Good morning students. Today we will discuss a new chapter, surface chemistry. Okay, surface chemistry. So surface chemistry is the branch of chemistry which deals with the study of surface phenomena. Surface and the substances present in the surface. So different kind of phenomena are happening in this chemical world, and the surface phenomena, what you know, those kind of things happening in the surface of a liquid or a solid. Okay, for example, if I take one example, see, whenever we are going for the heterogeneous catalytic reactions, in the heterogeneous catalytic reactions we are taking a catalyst, and that catalyst we are observing in the surface of a solid. The reactants, we are taking the reactants, and the reactants we are observing in the surface of a solid catalyst. So whenever there is a catalytic reaction, the catalyst, a solid catalyst, absorbs the reactants and give a space for the reactants to react. So that the reaction will be faster. So it's a surface phenomena. The reactants are absorbed as surface of the catalyst, and that give a better platform for the chemical reaction to occur. Similarly, we have seen that the cleaning up dirty clothes, where we are adding the detergent, we are adding the detergent to the water, okay, and the foams are being formed. That means the surface of the water, water, the phenomenon is happening, that is called the foams, okay, or the layers, the layers formed by the detergents which are removing the, you know, dirty particles from the cloth, happening on the surface. It's a surface phenomenon. So many examples are there where we are dealing with the only surface, that is called surface chemistry. Now basically in this surface chemistry we will discuss about adsorption, absorption, type of adsorption, okay, and what are the applications of this adsorption. Okay, first of all, we discuss what, you know, adsorption, A-D-S-O-R-P. What is the adsorption? Adsorption is the phenomenon of accumulation of liquid or gas molecules on the surface of a solid. Okay, so the phenomenon of accumulation of liquid or gas molecules on the surface of a solid is called what? Adsorption. And this adsorption is a surface phenomena, and it is an exothermic process. Whenever a certain amount of substance, liquid or gas, adsorbed on the surface of a solid, then what happens? The some amount of heat energy is released, hence this is known as an exothermic process. Okay, now for example, adsorption of ammonia on activated charcoal. Okay, so if you take activated charcoal, that can adsorb the ammonia gas, or you can say the activated charcoal can absorb your poisonous gases. Basically, in the industries where the poisonous gases are being manufactured, people are using the gas mask. In that gas mask, basically activated charcoal is being used, and that charcoal can absorb, that means the poisonous gases can absorb the surface of the charcoal. This is a surface phenomena adsorption. Similarly, if we can use the anhydrous, your piece of silica gel, if you use your piece of silica gel, by using the piece of silica gel can adsorb the water vapors, humidities. Whenever we are preparing a chemical substance, that chemical substance may contain water vapors, water particles are there. If you have a silica gel and we put the silica gel on the substance, then whatever kind of water vapors are there, that will adsorb on the surface of the silica gel. Okay, so this is called the phenomenon of adsorption. Okay, now what you know? So adsorption of ammonia gas on activated charcoal. Okay. Adsorption of water vapors on the surface of silica gel. Okay, or simply you can see, you see, you take a chalk piece where you are writing, take a chalk piece and just to dip in the water and take it out. You will see that the surface is wet. This is called also what you adsorption of liquid on solid. Okay, now then you know absorption AB. So what you know absorption is the phenomena of accumulation of liquid or gas molecules on the bulk of a solid, BULK, bulk of solid, as compared to surface of solid. Okay, for example, if you take your calcium chloride, and if you take, suppose you prepare a chemical substance that may contain some water vapors. Okay, now if you put the substance in a container containing calcium chloride, then calcium chloride is a good absorbent. It will absorb all the water vapors, water molecules there present in the substance, and that water molecules will go inside this calcium chloride. Okay, see, if I have here, this is called water absorption. So these are the water vapors, and if we have a silica gel here, now this is the surface of silica gel. So here what happens? Water vapors are adsorbed the surface of the silica gel. What happens? Zero anhydrous calcium chloride. Here you see, in the calcium chloride molecule, these are the water vapors. The water vapors are there inside this calcium chloride. Okay, तो इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रो एब्जॉर्प्शन, इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रो एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रो एडजॉर्प्शन. So this is hydro adsorption and absorption. Okay, so adsorption is a surface phenomena and absorption is a bulk phenomena. Okay, now the difference between adsorption and absorption. Okay, adsorption and absorption. First of all, the adsorption is a surface phenomena and absorption is a what you bulk phenomena. Okay, it is a surface phenomena bulk phenomena. Okay, the number adsorption, the rate of adsorption is rapid, but here the rate is uniform. The rate of absorption is uniform throughout, but this rate of absorption is rapid to start with, but decreases after. Okay, now another thing, important thing, you see, if I take your ammonia is absorbed by ammonia, is absorbed by charcoal, and water is absorbed by silica. But here you see ammonia is absorbed by water and water is absorbed by anhydrous calcium chloride. Okay, so here about the difference between adsorption and absorption. Okay, now let's see types of adsorption. Types of adsorption. The adsorption is of two kind. Physical adsorption or physioadsorption, and number two, केमिकल एडजॉर्प्शन और केमिजॉर्प्शन। ओके, सो वी हैव फिजिकल एडजॉर्प्शन और फिजिजॉर्प्शन एंड अदर केमिकल एडजॉर्प्शन और केमिजॉर्प्शन। नाउ व्हाट इज फिजिकल एडजॉर्प्शन? इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन व्हाट इज हैपनिंग? ए पर्टिकुलर मॉलिक्यूल लिक्विड और गैस मॉलिक्यूल्स इज एडजॉर्ब ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ ए सॉलिड। ओके, नाउ द गैस और द लिक्विड मॉलिक्यूल्स व्हिच आर एडजॉर्ब्ड, ओके, ऑन ए पार्टिकुलर सरफेस दे आर नोन एज एडजॉर्बेट एंड एडजॉर्बेंट। ओके, the surface on which the solid surface on which the liquid or gas molecules are adsorbed is known as the adsorbent, and the gas or liquids which are adsorbed is known as what, the adsorbent. Okay, so adsorbents are adsorbed in the adsorbent. So in the physical adsorption, in the physical adsorption, what happens? The gas molecules are held on the solid surface by weak van der Waals force of attraction. And this physical attraction between the liquid gas molecules and the solids is called what? The physical adsorption. Okay, so in physical adsorption or physiodorption, so the adsorbent and the adsorbent are held together by weak van der Waals force of attraction. Okay, for example, the adsorption of H2 or O2 in charcoal, when we have the charcoal, in the charcoal the H2 gas or the oxygen gas are being adsorbed. And here the H2 or O2 gas are not chemically attached, they are simply held on the surface of the charcoal by a weak van der Waals force of attraction, hence it is called what, physical adsorption or physiodorption. But next one is the chemical adsorption or chemiodorption. Here the adsorbent, okay, and the adsorbent are held together by a chemical bond, either ionic or covalent bond. So ionic or covalent bond is formed between the adsorbent and the adsorbent. For example, so whenever we are going for the heterogeneous catalytic reaction, so if you take a nickel catalyst, okay, and the hydrogen gas will be absorbed there, so the H2 molecules will be chemically attached with the nickel catalyst by forming the covalent bonds. So here it is called your chemiabsorption, right? So simply concept, whenever the adsorbent and adsorbent molecules are held together by weak van der Waals force of attraction, that is called what, physical adsorption. And whenever the adsorbent and adsorbent molecules are held together by chemical bond, either ionic or covalent bond, that is called what, the chemiabsorption. Okay, now and we'll see the difference between the physical adsorption and the chemical adsorption. Okay, now what are the differences between what you physical adsorption and what you chemical adsorption? Okay, let's see the physical and chemical adsorption. So What are the difference between physical and chemical adsorption? Now, in the physical adsorption, so the solid or the gas molecules are attached to the solid surface by weak van der Waals force. And this attachment is the gas, basically the gas molecules are attached when the gas are liquefied. So, the ease of adsorption of gases on the solid is depends upon the liquefaction of gases. The gases are easily liquefied, then they can absorb easily. But in chemination, there is no such correlations. Okay, so physical adsorption. Depends upon liquefaction of gases. No such things. Are required. Okay. The next thing, you know, the physical adsorptions, there is a weak van der Waals force of adsorption is present. But so, in chemical adsorption, there is what there is strong, you know, chemical bond force is present. Okay. Weak van der Waals force is present between adsorbent and adsorbent. You know what? Strong chemical bond force is present. Okay, so in case of physical adsorption, weak van der Waals force, but in case of chemical, it's what it is, strong chemical bond force. Okay, the next thing is what the it is a multi-layer multi-layer adsorption is what unilayer adsorption. Okay, that means we have the different layers, so one layer of adsorption and the layer and the layer, so each layer the adsorbent and adsorbent are attached to each other, so we have the different layers. But in case of chemical, so only we have a single layer, the chemically they are attached. Okay, then what do you know? Physical adsorption, it is reversible in nature. It is irreversible. Okay, so physical adsorption is what reversible, but chemical adsorption is what irreversible. That means once we have a particular solid, particular liquid or gas molecule adsorbed on the surface, the physically with help of van der Waals force, again that we can regain. But once chemically something is attached, that again we cannot rebreak it. Okay. It requires very small activation energy it requires लार्ज एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी. ओके, सो व्हेनेवर वी आर गोइंग फॉर द फिजिकल एडजस्टमेंट्स विद ए वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी वी कैन कैरी आउट द प्रोसेस, बट केमिकल केमिकल्स वी नीड ए हायर अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी टू एक्टिवेट द प्रोसेस. ओके, and many more points are there, many more points are there. Okay, out of this important things we have discussed now. Okay, now your applications of factors affecting adsorption of a gas by solid. Factors affecting absorption of gas on solid. So, what are the factors that are affecting the absorption of gas on solid? First of all, nature of gas. Actually, the absorption of gas on solid are affected by the nature of the gas, nature of the solid absorbent, प्रेशर ऑफ द गैस, टेम्परेचर, देन योर एक्टिवेशन ऑफ द एब्जॉर्बेंट एंड ऑफ द सरफेस एरिया. ओके, सो नेचर ऑफ द गैस, ओके, टेम्परेचर, प्रेशर, सरफेस एरिया ऑफ एब्जॉर्बेंट. ओके, नाउ सो वी हैव नेचर ऑफ सॉलिड एब्जॉर्बेंट. ओके, सो लेट्स सी हाउ दिस फैक्टर्स आर इफेक्टिंग द your absorption of your gas on the solid. First of all, the nature of the gas. See, if the gas which is going to be absorbed is easily liquefiable, then that can be easily absorbed. So easily liquefiable gases will be absorbed more easily, and those gases which are not easily liquefiable, they cannot absorb easily. Okay, number two, temperature. Temperature. See, if already a gas is absorbed on the surface of a solid, and if you heat it, then obviously the gas will come out. Okay, so the temperature. Okay, in case of absorption of a particular gas by some particular absorption, so the absorption decreases with increase of temperature. Okay. And next is what is the pressure. Okay, so here the with increasing temperature, the adsorption decreases, because already we know the adsorption is an exothermic process. Okay, now pressure, with increase of pressure, the adsorption will increase. Okay, if you increase the pressure, then more and more gases can be adsorbed. So the process of adsorption will increase with the help of what, the increase of pressure. Then surface area of absorbent. We know the gaseous molecules, the gas molecules are absorbed on the surface of the solid. So more the surface, more is the absorption. Okay, if we are having a larger surface area of the solid cartesian absorbent, then more and more amount of the gas molecules can be absorbed. Next, what is the nature of solid absorbent? See, because the gas molecules will be absorbed on surface, if the surface is a rough surface, then more gases can be absorbed. Or if the solid is finally divided also that can absorb more and more amount of your gases. Okay, so these are the different factors that are affecting the absorption of gases on solid. Applications of absorption. Applications of absorption. First, let's see there are various applications of the absorption. Like we are using the absorption in process of your gas mask. Okay, and also we are using dehumidifiers, okay, for removal of cooling materials, for drying up cloths, okay, and in chromatography, and main in also quantitative analysis, many kind of applications are there in for your absorption. Okay, so we'll discuss one by one. Okay, in gas masks, okay. You know, in a removal of cooling material, okay, as dehumidizer. Dying up cloths, okay, heterogeneous catalysis, okay, qualitative analysis. So there are some important applications of your absorption in gas mask. So wherever in industry, wherever the poisonous gases are being manufactured, so now we can use the gas mask, that concept of charcoal, actual charcoal. So that actual charcoal can absorb the poisonous gases. Okay. Removal of cooling material. So cooling materials also can be removed by using your charcoal. So basically in your sugar cane juice, we can remove the cooling materials by adding your charcoals. So sugar cane juice or from the vegetable substances, so we can remove the cooling material by adding your charcoal, activated charcoal. As a dehumidizer, so we are using your silica gel or NMS aluminum parts, okay, that can remove the water vapors, because they can other water vapors, that's why the humidity will be less and hence the your temperature can reduce. Okay, well, your dyeing up cloths, for dyeing up cloths, we are using your alum. So alum can be used as an absorbent. We can absorb the colors and that can stick to the cloths in a well manner. Then your heterogeneous catalysis, what? In case of heterogeneous catalytic reactions, we are using the catalyst and where the catalyst absorb the reacting molecules to give the chemical reactions. And also qualitative analysis, any qualitative analysis related to some kind of ions, also we can use adsorbent, we can use charcoal or some other kind of adsorbents we can use. These are the some important applications of your absorption. So this is about the surface chemistry. Now next we will go for your catalysis. Okay.